Congratulations and thanks for choosing Heatstar Quality. Life's about to get a whole lot more comfortable. Now let's get started. Step 1, unpack the unit and make sure all the parts are present and accounted for. Next, choose where and how the unit will be installed. For all installations, the bottom of the heater must be at least 8 feet above the floor. You must also have at least 18 inches of rear clearance for gas, electrical, ducting, and fan access. For parking structures or hangars, you'll need permission from local building authorities for installations below 8 feet and a way to prevent damage from vehicles passing underneath. There are a number of mounting options, rods, mounting brackets, or directly to framing. Just leave at least 1 inch between the ceiling and the unit. All new heaters are configured for natural gas when shipped, with the liquid propane conversion kit included. For LP applications, a qualified gas installer must install the LP conversion kit per instructions before installing the heater. The length of the gas supply line from meter to heater will determine the correct pipe size to maintain proper pressure. Line pressure for natural gas should be 7-inch water column. Line pressure for propane should be 13-inch water column. Use a flexible gas line from a shutoff valve to the gas connection to the heater, with a 1/2-inch female gas connection into the back of the unit. Electrical connection requires a minimum of 15-amp service. 50,000 BTU units draw 3 amps, while 80,000 BTU units draw 6 amps. Unit heaters must be vented in compliance with all local codes or requirements of the local utility. Air for combustion and ventilation must be provided in accordance with the latest edition of Section 5.3, Air for Combustion and Ventilation, of the National Fuel Gas Code. That's ANSI Z223.1 in the U.S., in Canada CSA B149.1, of the Natural Gas and Propane Installation Code and applicable provisions of local building codes. If indoor air will be used for combustion, it must be free of contaminants to avoid reduced unit lifespan. The metal transition supplied with the certified unit must not be modified or altered, and all joints must be secured with at least 2 corrosion-resistant screws and checked for gas tightness after installation. Failure to comply will void certification of the unit. For venting, always follow local building codes. For vertical venting with metal vent pipe, all units are considered Category 1 appliances. 50,000 BTU units can use 3-inch vertical flue piping. 80,000 BTU units must use 4-inch vertical venting. All horizontal venting must be Category 3, stainless steel sealed ducting. You can order complete vent kits where you purchased your heater. Remember, electrical connections require a minimum of 15 amp service. 50,000 BTU units draw 3 amps, while 80,000 BTU units draw 6 amps. This unit uses a direct spark ignition system. No pilot is necessary, since the spark lights the main burner when the gas valve is turned on. You'll need a 3-wire, 110-volt AC electrical supply, a hot, a neutral, and a ground for proper operation, connected at the back of the heater in the single gang junction box. Below the junction box is a terminal strip with 4 screw terminals for the remote thermostat connection. Only the terminals marked R and W are needed for the thermostat. If your thermostat has a manual automatic fan switch setting, attach a 3rd wire to the optional G terminal. Under normal, power-on conditions, but with the thermostat turned down, not calling for heat, a green LED will flash steady once per second, indicating the unit is in standby. When the thermostat is turned up, calling for heat, the following sequence occurs. The LED will start flashing twice per second. The induced draft or exhaust motor will start up in a purge cycle, pulling air through the burner tubes and blowing it out the exhaust to vent unburnt fumes and create the exhaust draft. After 30 seconds, with the induced draft motor still running, the electrode starts sparking. Just after the electrode starts sparking, the gas valve will open with a loud click. All burners must then light. The electrode keeps sparking for 10 seconds. If all the burners are lit, a flame sensor signals the control board to stop sparking. After 30 seconds with the burners on, the outside blower fan will start blowing air across the heat exchanger tubes and pushing heat into the room. Troubleshooting. If the unit fails to operate, check the following. Is the green LED on and flashing on the circuit board? If the LED does not light, check the 3 amp fuse in the top left corner of the circuit board. If the fuse is okay, check the main power to the unit, power wire connections, and 24 volt AC from a transformer to the board. Is the thermostat calling for heat? Is the main disconnect powered up? Is there a breaker tripped or a fuse blown? Is the gas turned on at the meter and the heater? Is the manual shutoff on the gas valve on? Is the unit ignition system in lockout? 2 flash code on green LED on the circuit board? Is the pressure switch closed? An obstruction flue will prevent the pressure switch from closing. Check outside vent for blockage, bird or insect nests. Check inside the heater where air tube connects to the exhaust fan for blockage. If the startup sequence fails at any point, the LED on the circuit board will flash a trouble code indicating where the fault lies. The LED will flash in different sequences when the various sensors detect a problem and prevent a dangerous condition. The 2 flash code will appear when the flame sensor does not detect a proper burn. This may happen because the electrode doesn't spark to light the gas burners, the gas valve doesn't open, so no gas flows past the electrode, not all the burners ignite, so the flame sensor shuts down the unit. Consult the owner's manual, visit heatstarbyenerco.com or call 1-800-251-0001 for specific instructions to troubleshoot these conditions in proper order. The 3 flash code usually indicates a clogged exhaust pipe or pressure switch feed tube. The 4 flash code can indicate any of a number of problems. Wind blowing down the exhaust pipe or a blockage causing the flame to roll back into the burner area. Incorrect manifold pressure setting when converting from liquid propane to natural gas fuel. The top burner letting off flame above the burner wing outlet, normally used to light the next burner in line. A malfunctioning rollout switch. Incorrect blower fan RPM or a loose fan blade. Loose insulation blocking airflow across the heat exchanger tube. A faulty circuit board. For these and other problems, consult the owner's manual. Visit heatstarbyenerco.com or call 1-800-251-0001 for troubleshooting help and repairs. Be sure to shut off all gas and electrical power to the unit before performing any maintenance or service. Any replacement wiring must have a temperature rating of at least 105 degrees Celsius. Before each heating season, inspect burners for any deposits or blockage. During heating season, periodically inspect burner flames for proper appearance. To clean burners, turn off electrical gas supplies. Disconnect gas supply piping, high tension, and sensor leads. Remove the gas manifold, then remove the panel that the circuit board bolts to get access to the burners. Clean burners as necessary. When reinstalling the burner, be sure the heads line up properly to ensure flame crossover. Check spark gap on electrode and adjust if required. The gap should be between 0.110 inch and 0.14 inch, which is 2.79 millimeters to 3.56 millimeters. Use appropriately sized twist drills or feeler gauges to check the gap. The flue passages and flue box should be inspected and cleaned prior to each heating season. To do so in sequence, turn off electrical and gas supplies, disconnect combustion air blower wiring, remove screw securing flue box to the unit, remove flue box. If necessary, remove blower assembly from flue box. Clean flue box with wire brush. Remove turbulator retention bracket and turbulators. Clean turbulators with wire brush. Remove burners as previously shown. Clean tubes with wire brush. Reassemble unit. The combustion, air, and flue box gaskets should also be replaced during reassembly. Under normal operating conditions, the combustion air blower should be checked and cleaned prior to the heating season. With the power supply disconnected, use a small brush to clean the blower. All unit heaters carry a 3-year warranty on the parts and a 10-year warranty on the heat exchanger assembly. If you experience any problems with operation, troubleshooting, repair, or replacement parts, contact Heatstar directly. While under warranty, we will ship any part that fails to operate correctly or fails due to manufacturing defect directly to you. Simply provide the unit's serial number. If the unit is beyond the warranty period, we will need a proof of purchase to supply warranty parts. For more information, call 1-800-251-0001 or contact us on the web